Yeah, it's full of megas here. Or you can just call me Autumn. That's the English translation of my first name. This will be my second reaction video. And I don't know if you noticed, but I'm recording this on my table this time, and I'm recording it through my phone because the last time I was recording through my computer, and I think I had some issues with my voice. There was a synchronization problem with that. I'll try to record this through my phone. I hope it looks better. I hope my voice is clear. I don't know. But anyways, yeah, today I'll be watching Ruby Volume 5, Episode 2, Dread in the Air. So yeah. Before I go to the reaction video, I just wanted to tell I watched the Ruby Rewind episode. So I've seen the sneak peek. I know at the beginning of the episode, I don't know if it's the beginning, but anyways, so I know that we're gonna see Wise fighting with the Wasp Grimms. I mean, it was kind of obvious because of the trailer, so it's not really a surprise that we're gonna see that. But I'm so hyped for this. My body is ready for this, so I just want to watch this now. So, Ruby Volume 5, Episode 2 starts in 3, 2, 1, and now.
Are we
Lionheart.
ready?
Oh, okay. Oh my god, that smile. Are they going to see Salem or something? I'm not so sure. Oh god, he really looks scared. What a surprise. Oh, that creepy jellyfish thing.
After you. Your Grace, are you there?
Oh.
Hello, Leonardo. Do you have something to report?
Of course, ma'am. I would not waste your time if not. I'm still just so fascinated by this creature. Cinder, dear, are we coming through? Can you see us clearly?
Oh, God.
As clearly as you can.
Get her face.
Oh, goody. You've recovered.
Your report. What is it?
I've found the Spring Maiden.
Is that so? Well done, Arthur. Had I known how useful you'd be in expediting this process, I would have sent you long, long ago.
As much as I'd love to take credit, ma'am, I can't say that either of us are to thank for this development. I guess you could say a little birdie told us.
Explain.
A little birdie.
You see, ma'am, Crow Bronwyn arrived at Haven Academy earlier today. He believes Spring has taken residence with his sister's tribe.
Is the girl with him?
Well, she can talk
yes,
now.
Yes, Miss Rose was in attendance.
And she's looking for Ruby.
And you know of the tribe's location?
Yes, ma'am. But you have to hurry. Crow is already at odds with my...
Leonardo?
Dear owner.
Do you remember the first time we met? I remember. I remember your fear. But since that day, you've been extraordinarily brave.
Brave, seriously?
I won't forget all that you've done for me. Do not forget everything I can do to you.
Oh, is she gonna kill him? No, right? She still needs him.
Cinder, you and your team will meet with Dr. Watts and together convince Raven Bronwyn that the survival of her people depends on her cooperation. Once you have Spring under control, escort her to the Relic and contact Hazel. The White Fang was promised the destruction of Haven, and they'll have it once we have.
Convince Raymond?
Understood.
Not you, Arthur. Tyrion's in need of a new tale.
What happened to his old one?
Guess.
They can make tales?
The silver-eyed girl.
Oh, Cinder looks angry.
It will be done.
Good.
Seems Crow was right, Lionheart. The students aren't pushovers.
Yeah, they're not.
You're free to speak your mind.
I don't understand. Working with bandits? Keeping Ruby alive? What's the point? We're strong enough to take what we want by force.
Never underestimate the usefulness of others. Take Leonardo. He was one of Ospin's most trusted, and yet now... You will have the power I promised you when the time is right. But remember that it comes with a cost.
What
if Ruby Rose has learned to harness her gift, then you must take care to protect yours. There's only so much I can do to aid you.
Okay.
And Cinder, before you go, inform Tyrion that I wish to have a word with him.
Wow. I love Cinder. Oh, here she is. It's from the Snake Peak. So, Salem wants to keep Ruby alive, so maybe someday she can use her too. And oh my god, they're going after bandits. They're gonna threat Raven.
Where are
And Yank will be there.
No, we're good. Passing by some of Lake Matsu's floating islands.
Yank will be there.
The gravity dust that
I'm so hyped.
Turbulence. Nothing
I'm so hyped.
Handle, but the islands sometimes hide some nasty grim.
And this is interesting. The Flying islands, it's so weird.
Distress, them
they're great.
Look out!
And here they come. I can't wait to see Weiss in action.
To be kidding me.
Because we haven't been seeing this since Volume 3. I can't wait to see her summoning. She's like so OP now. She's so strong. She's like an army. Oh, the Vast Grimms. They look great.
Everyone abandon ship!
The animation's so good. Okay. Okay, I'm ready. My body's ready.
Lancers. Freaking Lancers. Alright, buckle up!
Oh god. This music.
What are you doing?
What we should have done in the first place.
Yeah.
You're carrying dust, right?
Officially, no. Actually, yes.
Then when I tell you, open the rear door.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Better make it quick.
Officially, yes. Actually, no. Oh, Weiss, I missed you. Yeah. Oh. Oh my god! That effect! Oh my god.
Hold on!
You got this. Oh my god.
idea. Hold on. Literally.
Literally. Nice move.
Can you find a pair of islands we can fit between?
Kid, you are reading my mind.
Mirror, mirror is playing, I think.
Yeah! Great going, kid! We are in the clear!
Something's coming, yeah.
It's a Queen Lancer!
What?
It's a what? I didn't get that. They're so quiet. Mirror, mirror. Oh no, it's our new trailer music. Yeah.
Do something!
Oh no, it's Volume 4 music. Path to Isolation, I think. Oh my god, you're awesome! You're so powerful! Oh my god! Is there anything that she can't do? Oh my god.
I can see the shoreline! God! We're not gonna make it!
No, you're gonna make it! Okay, summoning is coming. Show us that armor. Oh my god, look at this animation. Oh my god, it is gorgeous. It doesn't have his sword, I think. Yeah, he's just... Oh my god! Oh my god, this is so good. Oh, he's got his sword now. Oh shit. Oh my god. Okay, they're falling now. Holy shit. She's like,
Adam.
Oh my god. Okay.
I'm not going to repeat myself. So I want you to listen.
Sienna Khan.
Tell you that the White Fang will not attack Haven Academy.
Okay.
High Leader Khan, I am begging you.
You should beg for forgiveness and nothing else. The assault you led on Beacon was not the great victory you clearly think it was. And you should be grateful your punishment wasn't more severe.
What punishment?
You are a symbol for many in our organization, but that doesn't make you infallible.
I was merely trying to follow your example, High Leader.
And what example might that be?
Strength. Strength and unwavering conviction. The humans have seen that strength now.
I was one of the first to suggest violence where violence was necessary. Peace bred complacency, an acceptance of our place in the world. I will not allow humanity to push us down without pushing them back. But the destruction of the Huntsman Academies crosses a line. The loss of the CCT has brought global communication to a crawl, and the White Fang is more of a target now than ever before.
You have justified humanity's campaign against us. And for what? Empty promises from a group of humans? Humans we still know nothing about and come and go as they please. These are not examples of strength, Adam. They are examples of your talents being diminished by short-sightedness.
Wow. I like her.
If you want to know more about the humans, then why not talk to one of them yourself?
Which one?
Hazel!
Oh yeah, of course, Hazel. Oh god. I want to hear your
Took
voice.
Took you long enough.
What is this?
Apologies. I don't aim to cause any trouble.
You've brought a human to this location?
You should hear what he has to say.
This is grounds for execution.
Ma'am, please. Nobody needs to die today. I'm just asking for a moment of your time.
The longer you stay here, the less of a chance you have of leaving alive.
I'll take those chances, if you don't mind. You don't like me. You have no reason to like me. But you don't have to like me to get the results you want.
I'm starting to doubt either of you fully comprehend what it is that I want. I want humanity to fear the Faunus, to know that we demand respect. I do not want to start a war with the humans that we cannot win.
That's where you're wrong. We can win a war against the humans. Not only because we have the support of Hazel's master, but because the Faunus are the dominant species of this planet. We're better than humans. We have everything humans have and more. Humans shouldn't just fear the Faunus. They should serve the Faunus.
Oh, God.
I've had enough of this conversation for tonight. Guards, take them away. I said take them away.
Oh no.
I will admit, Sienna.
They're with Adam.
You were right about my popularity. My followers in Vale already see me as the true High Leader. And many here in Mistral feel the same.
Oh no.
What are you doing?
Oh,
what's right for the Faunus? From this day forward, I will be the one to lead the White Fang.
If you think I'll just step aside and follow beneath you, you're wrong.
So soon?
I know.
Holy fuck!
Thank you, Sienna.
You were there when our people needed you. But they need me now.
But I liked her!
I'm sorry you couldn't see this through to the end. Give our former leader a proper burial. All who were here tonight will claim that Sienna was murdered by a human huntsman. Sienna Khan will become a martyr for our cause. Her final act as High Leader.
I have a hard time in processing things right now. Hazel didn't like this.
When were you planning on telling me about that?
This was my business.
Oh god, that fucking
not
sword.
Not yours.
It's our business now. And I don't appreciate you withholding things like that.
Your master was concerned with Sienna's willingness to cooperate. Now she doesn't have to be.
Nobody needed to die today.
I like Hazel, to be honest. He's interesting, but...
I disagree.
Holy shit, Adam. Oh boy. It's only the second episode. Oh. Who is that? Are they bandits? I'm just assuming things right now.
Please.
Holy shit!
What do you think?
Raven found Weiss?
I think. We just hit the jackpot.
Holy shit! Holy shit! Oh my god. I'm sorry, I'm freaking out! Oh my god, is it over? What? I didn't see that coming. I didn't see that coming at all. Like, okay, I'm just gonna wait until this the credits are over. Ooh, my heart. Okay. This was so short, but it's not. I don't know. How did the time pass? Oh my god, this was too short. No, but it's not. Okay. Raven found Weiss. Fucking Raven found Weiss. I didn't see that coming at all. I always assume in the trailer when Raven was looking down, I always assumed that it was Yank, you know? So yeah, now to think about it, I'm sorry, I'm so excited, I can't talk. In the poster, I'm gonna put the poster here, Yank and Weiss were looking at the same direction, like they were together, but Ruby and Blake was looking different directions, so... We're gonna see Yang and Weiss reunion first, I think. But oh my god, I'm gonna see Raven in the third episode. Oh my god, this is great. This is awesome. And she's like, oh, you just hit the jackpot. I wonder why she said that. Maybe she knows she's a Schnee from how she looks. Oh god, this episode was like 90% of villains episode, and I love villains, by the way. I mean, I love hating them. I mean, just the villains in Ruby are so cool. Oh my god, I need to process this. Okay, I'm gonna start from the beginning. So Reinhardt and Watts talked with Salem, and Reinhardt told Salem that we're the Spring Maidens. And then I think I might not catch that very well, but Watts is going after the Spring Maiden, and I think they're gonna make a new tale for Tyrion. I didn't know they can make that. Cinder was angry because Salem wants to keep Ruby alive. But Cinder is like, oh, I just wanna kill her, let me kill her. Oh, and Cinder is also going after the Spring Maiden, and I'm so curious about what's gonna happen next. That this means Weiss, Yang, Raven, Watts. I'm still not sure about Watts. I might hear that wrong. I have to watch it again. Oh, I forgot which ones I counted. Weiss, Yang, Cinder, Raven, they're all gonna be in the same place. They'll all be in the tribe. I'm so curious how Weiss will react, because I don't think Weiss knows that Raven is Yang's mom. I mean, even John knows, but I think they learn that while they were in their way to Mistral, because it was a long journey, so I assume they shared a lot of personal stuff. But I don't think Weiss knows that, so it's gonna be a shocking surprise for Weiss. It's gonna be very shocking for Yang when she arrives at the tribe and sees Weiss as a prisoner. I mean, come on. Oh my god, I'm like, oh boy, this episode was great. Oh my god. And then we fucking Adam. His outfit is great. He has a cool outfit. And he was talking with Sienna. Oh, fuck. I mean, I liked Sienna, okay? I liked her. But, like, 30 seconds after I decided that I liked her, he fucking killed her. Like. But actually, someone in Tumblr, I don't remember their name, mentioned that the historical character that they used for Sienna Khan has a fear of fire, and that fire called Red Flower or Red Rose, I'm not so sure, and he mentioned that in Adam's back there is a motive of a red flower. So when I seen that post, I immediately understood that yeah, Sienna is gonna die, but I didn't expect it to be this soon, you know. I mean, it's the fucking second episode, okay, so a lot of shit is going on. So Sienna was violent at first. She achieved her purpose. Humans are scared of the Faunus, but she doesn't want a war between humans and Faunus. And she doesn't trust Salem and her team, but Adam thinks otherwise. He knows how powerful Salem is, that's why he thinks that they can win the war, and he mentioned how Faunus is the best species in Earth. Because I think he might be right, because I mean they're humans and they have like extra abilities like night vision, or some of them has claws, better ear, better hearing. So he's right. Fucking Adam. He just wiped his sword, and then that damn sword. Okay, I hate Adam. I fucking hate Adam because he chopped off my favorite character's arm. But I love hating him. He's a great villain. He's amazing, he's so cool, he's so powerful, I love his design, and he's just so interesting now. He leads the White Fang. And I assume Blake doesn't know that yet, because I still think that Blake's arc is in the past, so she might know it now. I don't know, I'm not gonna go there, but she's gonna learn eventually. And oh my god. Oh, Hazel. I didn't talk about Hazel. I love Hazel. I loved him when I first saw him in Volume 4 because that damn voice. I mean, come on. And then we got a scene that he helped Oscar. You know, he doesn't look that evil. I mean, when you compare to him to Tyrion or Adam or Cinder, he's like the good guy from the villains. I mean, he wasn't yeah, he was kind of angry to Adam because Adam didn't mention his plan to kill Sienna Khan to Hazel. So he was like, oh, hey, we're doing a business together, so I have to know this stuff, you know? And he was like, oh, that was unnecessary. No one had to die today. Like, Adam doesn't give a shit. You, your boss, wasn't trust Sienna, so she doesn't have to worry anymore. Simple and clean solution. Fucking Adam. Oh boy. Oh, I completely forgot Weiss's fight scene. I mean, that was amazing. I mean, there's nothing she can do, she can't do with dust. She becomes so powerful with dust. I mean, all the stuff she's done, like, what the hell? And she was like, I think she can see through the armor's eyes because she was controlling the armor through inside of the ship, but she was clearly can see it, and she can use her glyphs with the armor, and I become so excited. I'm so sorry, I lost my coolness. And I have a hard time speaking in English because, like, I was almost gonna start talking in my native language because I'm like so excited, and I can't express my feelings with English right now because my mind is just blown away by the episode. So, next episode we're gonna see Raven and her tribe, and hopefully other members of Team Ruby. Oh my god, this season is gonna be amazing, it already is. And it's the second episode, I'm losing my shit. And it's, we got 12 more episodes, 12 more episodes. Hype is real. So I'm so excited to analyze stuff right now. I mean, I wasn't this much excited in the first episode. Things are going down. Oh, and I mentioned that I'm gonna make a Raven video. I want to talk about Raven a little bit, and I think now is the time because I'm 90% sure that we're gonna see Raven in episode 3. So I'm gonna talk about Raven. I'm gonna post the Raven. I'm gonna post about my video about Raven this week, but I will upload this video next Saturday. So I think you guys will see the Raven video first, and then you're gonna see this one. So yeah, I think the video is already there now while you're watching this. I don't have anything else to say. Like, they're going after Spring Maiden and they're gonna try to convince Raven by threatening her the lives of the people in her tribe. Oh my god. And Weiss is in the fucking tribe. I'm still not over this. I never thought about this. Like, I never thought about this. Not thought about this. And I think we've seen all the scenes in the trailer, so I have no clue about what's gonna happen next. Because like that trailer was all from chapter 1 and chapter 2 and the character shorts, obviously. So we have nothing more. But I'm gonna watch the Ruby Rewind because I'm so impatient. So I want to see the sneak peek. Because I'm like so excited already, and the next episode is weeks away. But we're gonna see Raven, guys. I'm gonna lose my shit. I'm gonna lose my shit when I see Raven. I will. So I just want to make sure that I'll make a Raven episode before the episode 3 comes out. So I'm gonna make sure of that. Because I want to talk about her. I love talking about her. I love thinking about her. And oh boy, I'm ready. Or not, I'm not ready. I'm excited as hell. Anyways, I don't want to make this video like the other one because it was like so long and I'm already in 36 minutes or 37. So I'm just gonna wrap it up. I couldn't analyze stuff clearly because I'm losing my shit. So I really love this episode. I'm sure you guys can see that clearly. Oh, by the way, if you haven't seen my first episode, I'm sorry, English is not my first language and I don't use it in my daily life, so I'm sorry if I did some grammar mistakes. I'm sure as hell that I did because I lost my shit. Okay, so I might do that. I might done that. So sorry about that. So yeah, this was my second reaction video, and I love making reaction videos. I don't know what you guys are thinking about my reaction videos, but I'll making them, and I think I'm gonna continue making them because it's so good to share my excitement with other people, because there's like literally no one that watches Ruby in I'm not even sure in my country people are watching Ruby. I don't think people are watching Ruby in my country. At most 100 people, I'm assuming, in the whole country knows what Ruby is. But I convinced one of my friends and she watched it, and I'm like talking with her all the time, so she's like okay. But she liked it, and I'm glad she did. And it's really nice to share my excitement with you guys. So I hope you like the video. I'm gonna shut my mouth now. So I hope you enjoyed my second reaction video. I'm still new at this. I'm still new at editing videos, uploading them on YouTube. It takes so much time. But I like this. So I hope I see you guys on the next one. So take care.